So proof of stake is like synthetic proof of work. So the idea is, can we get all the theoretical properties and all the niceties that proof of work provides, but pay none of the energy costs? Can we simulate mining in a certain way? That's all it is, basically. And so we've created a protocol called Ouroboros, which is quite well thought out. But there are many other protocols like Casper and Tendermint and so forth, but they all have the same goal. Do the same thing mining does, achieve the same level of decentralization that mining has, but pay none of the energy cost and also pay none of the coordination costs and so forth. It's like saying you can drive across the country and you don't use any gas. It's the same deal here. You know, mining costs something to do something, and what proof of stake is a disruptive order of magnitude reduction in the cost of running the algorithm. IOHK is basically an engineering firm as well as a science firm. So on the science side, we actually are concerned about the science of cryptocurrencies. So we have research centers at universities, we write papers, and on the engineering side, we actually construct cryptocurrencies from the ground up. As with all emerging fields, usually you have a sudden innovation that convinces people this is a good idea, but that innovation is usually heuristically inspired. In other words, it's been created by an engineer, not a scientist. So the underlying scientific foundations of why this works and what is secure, what is not secure, how do we scale, all of these things, they're not quite solved yet. So one of the areas we realized was vastly underdeveloped, atrophied in the cryptocurrency space, was the actual science side of it. So what we wanted to do is create a network of university partners and researchers and work with them so that we could write papers that would provide solid foundations for all projects, not just Ethereum or BitShares or Bitcoin, but basically anybody who wants to know what is a secure ledger, how do we scale, how do we handle privacy, these types of concerns. Let's give them strong theoretical guarantees, let's let those guarantees go through peer review, and let's have actually real scientists write these things as opposed to, you know, some 25-year-old engineer who came out of Silicon Valley.